Namaskaram. Namaskaram. Welcome, everyone. Welcome. I guess only a few people are here. Namaskaram, Biplav ji. Namaskaram, Balaji ji. I'm seeing you for the first time. Namaskaram. Welcome. Nimiya ka namaskaram. And Hariharan ji is also here. Namaskaram, Hariharan Mohdaya. We'll get started. It takes some time for the engines to warm up, even in the digital age. This is the first time we are streaming live on multiple platforms. Okay, wow, there are 100 viewers already on YouTube. Namaskaram to everybody watching on YouTube, on both the Madras Sanskrit channel page and on the Sanskrit channel. Namaskaram. Shubhasayam sarvebhyah. Adhyatana karyakramah prayah kinchit samskrita madhyamena api bhavitum arhati. Harihara mahodaya asti idanim. Pashyamaha katham gachati iti. Astu. So welcome. Welcome everyone. Shubhasayam sarvebhyah. I'll also, of course, we are assembled here on a special day. I'll wish you all in a few minutes. But we'll wait for a couple of more minutes. It's just 7 p.m. We'll wait for one more minute for more people to join in. I hope everybody is doing good. You're all safe and healthy. Namaskaram. More people joining in. Lal ji, namaskaram. And Bhavani ji, namaskaram. Guys who are watching on YouTube, as an incentive for the first few hundred people who are watching on YouTube, of course, this event is happening live on Crowdcast and is being streamed to YouTube. If you want to join us live on YouTube and want to join via video, you can join using this link. I'm pinning it in both the Madras Sanskrit channel page and the Sanskrit channel page. You can join using this link. We have only a few people. Only the patrons and YouTube members have joined in on YouTube. So you guys, the first few hundred viewers on your YouTube can also join in. And the password for this event, only for the first few hundred viewers, is MSC-Live, all smalls. If you wish to, you can join us here. Yes, I'm typing it correctly. This is the password. The 10 people watching on Madras Sanskrit channel page, namaskaram. Namaskaram, all of you. And of course, welcome back to all the regular viewers of the Sanskrit channel. Naveen ji, welcome. Welcome to Crowdcast. More people joining in. Yash ji, namaskaram. Welcome. Guys on YouTube, you can join us on Crowdcast if you wish to using the pinned comment. More people who are joining now, use the pinned comment and the password MSC-Live on Crowdcast. You can join us via video if you wish to, if you're on Crowdcast. But if you're on YouTube, you'll only be able to interact via chat and just see us through video and audio. But if you want to interact with us, ask questions, participate, you can come to Crowdcast. All right, having said that, sarvebhyah swatantrya dinasya shubhashayah. Wish you all a very happy Independence Day of Bharat. And this evening, we have many firsts. This is the first time I'm in conversation with a college, a university, that too, the Madras Sanskrit, the Madras Sanskrit College to begin with, of course, no less than the Madras Sanskrit College itself, to have a first conversation with a university. Some of the people whom I have been interacting with over the past 3 years know a little bit that I have a little bit of a disdain for these large organizations and institutions, especially because they are of such giant size. Usually, they also move and operate at a pace which is fit for their size and stature. They are extremely slow to respond and all that stuff. But this particular institution, Madras Sanskrit College, the speed at which they responded and the speed at which they worked, and I learned something new today to multi-stream. Of course, interacting with the university, I had to learn something new from them as well. So this time, I mean, of course, going forward also, they will make an exception to also interact with these institutions of enormous antiquity. It's as it has such a hoary past. It's an institute of almost more than a century old, but still they have a digital wing. They are abreast with the times. They are keeping up. They have come up with apps. They are seeing how to cater to an increasingly digital audiences, to a global audiences. We look at all of this with Hariharanji. And of course, I have a couple of lines written about the institute and what we are going to do. So quickly, the overview of the session. Initially, I'll give you a quick introduction about what the series is called as Sanskrit Showcase, and why this particular part of the series where we interact with institutions started. Then I'll talk to you a little bit about the college itself, the institute, and then Hariharanji, who is going to who is the director of Digital Campus, who is here to present the courses offered, and then he will be presenting his presentation. And then if you have any questions, you can ask us in ask a question section. YouTube, most probably the questions might not be addressed because there is so much chat happening. On Madras Sanskrit College, of course, we'll take comments and questions from there. On the Sanskrit channel page, guys, the number of comments, we don't know if I can even distinguish between questions. Again, one final time before we have more people joining in, you can join us on Crowdcast using this link that I've pinned on YouTube and the password MSC-live. All right. Sai Kiranji, what did I promise? Anyways, we'll come to questions later. Why did I start with universities? Yes. This whole story started almost 1.5 months ago. It started when I did this ask a questions section, ask me anything section on Instagram. On July Ask Me Anything sessions, one plus 12 student, she asked, Bhaiya, I'm in plus 12, I'm finishing it, and I want to pursue a course in Sanskrit. What are my options? And this has been a consistent question. I've noticed this question pop up at multiple instances throughout my presenting content on YouTube. And one thing that I noticed was I've never really paid attention to all the institutions, such eminent institutions across the country. And I thought when I was doing, I finished my college, my 10th and then my intermediate, or 10 plus 2 as they call it in some parts of the country, I did not have much exposure to what kind of courses or what kind of opportunities are there for me to pursue Sanskrit in a more serious way. So I guess at one level, I felt that it is the same case with many other students who might have that same desire, that same zeal to pursue something in Sanskrit, but they do not have the means or the know-how of how to approach these institutions or what kind of courses are available even. So immediately I made a database of all the Sanskrit institutions in Bharat and across the world. It's still a work in progress. I've collected as many details as I can about all these institutions. And I put their email IDs, their website links, and their, the courses they have to offer and all that. And the courses were not exactly detailed, but after I built that database, which is accessible at bit.ly/si-database, this is a Google spreadsheet, I reached out. I did not have much hope that anybody or all of them or I hoped that a few people at least would get back to me. And I messaged a first few of these institutions saying, guys, I'm a Sanskrit teacher on YouTube. I have a channel like this. And I would love to have you present your courses on the channel. And to not much of my surprise, some of the email IDs did not even function properly. The email IDs that they had on their websites, some of them had not that great quality websites also, unfortunately. But a few people, to my surprise and to my content, got back to me immediately. Madras Sanskrit College was the first of them. The trustees, and the people on the faculty, the speed with which they work, the enthusiasm and the zeal with which they want to present that content to more people, it was so inspiring. So we are privileged today to start this session, the Sanskrit Showcase session, where we'll be talking about courses that Madras Sanskrit College offers. Coming to a few words quickly about the college itself, it was founded in 1906, much before independence, by one of the luminaries of Bharat, the former judge of Madras High Court, Honorable V. Krishnaswamy Iyer. Madras Sanskrit College has an illustrious history of more than a century. As I said, I have written a few words about it. And it is, now that I've written it, I've written a few words. They don't do much justice. They have been working tirelessly and they have so many courses. They offer courses in bachelor's level, master's degree programs in Jyotisham, Vyakarana, Sahitya, Mimamsa, Vedanta, Nyaya. And last year, I got to know that they have started MPhil courses and PhD courses for, and there are many students who have enrolled in these research programs and they are continuing their areas of research. And in 2017, they started a digital wing to enable access to these systems of education globally. They also have an app where one can access digital courses, short stories. Hariharanji was involved in building an app which has a shloka a day, and I'll let him talk about it more, of course. And they have, of course, their own presence on social media platforms like YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter with thousands of active followers and who are here among us. Welcome to the other 20 people who have joined us and watching. Namaskaram. And punaha ekavaram sarvebhyah swatantrya dinasya subhashayah. Astu. I also wanted to, I had a quick word with Hariharanji. Of course, I've been in touch with the faculty people. And Hariharanji said, no, let's, when I asked him about a few words about himself, how should I introduce him? He said, no, let's jump directly into the topic. And that is when I know this is my kind of people. But I'd fall short if I did not at least introduce him to some extent. So he's the director of the digital campus at Madras Sanskrit College. And he's going to be in conversation now. He's going to be presenting the courses of the college, and he'll be also addressing some of the questions that we all might have. And also, he is an accomplished Sanskrit scholar with a long list of academic achievements to his merit. He has been educated in many prestigious Sanskrit universities, where he again got a long list of medals and honors. And I'll, of course, link Dr. Hariharan's profile in the description below. For those of you who are interested, you can go through his profile, how he did his education, where he started, what kind of achievements he had, and how he is now working towards taking Sanskrit to more and more people in working in Madras Sanskrit College. All right. Now I'll invite Hariharanji to take it away. Of course, there is a small audio visual that we are going to present. I'll invite Hariharanji first on screen, and then we all let's watch that audio visual together. He typed his name in Devanagari. महोदय भवान् तु देवनागरी मध्ये लिखितवान् तद् अन्वेषणार्थं किञ्चित् कष्टाय कुत्र अस्ति महोदयः अस्तु लब्धम् आह्वानं प्रेषितवान् महोदय भवान् एक्सेप्ट् करोतु
हरि ओम् नमस्कारः
धन्यवादः स्वागतम् आदौ
धन्यवादः
इदानीं तद् आडियो विजुवल् पश्यामः
सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति 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 मनविदे भूरिभागे निषन्नम् त्रिभुवनगुरुमी सन्दक्षिणामूर्तिदेवम्
ेतवोज्जेतवाय्वस्था देवो वाह सविता परार्पयत् श्रेष्ठतमाय कर्मण
इन्द्रपुरोडाशः आग्नेयं पयः इति स्थलद्वयम् उदाहरणत्वेन दीयते। ऐन्द्रपुरोडाशः इत्यत्र कीदृशी शङ्का भवति? इयं विकृतिः किं प्रकृतिकत्वम् अस्याः इति निर्णेतव्यम्।
फोर् टैम् मेमोरियल् in this country, for the intellectual elite, the language of communication used to be only Sanskrit. It's despite the fact that various regional languages also thrived at the same time, the intellectual discourse concentrated only using Sanskrit. Sanskrit was the very basis of the source of knowledge for this country for a long number of years. With the development of the regional languages, while there was a very healthy exchange of views and ideas between the regional languages as well as Sanskrit, it's only subsequent to the advent of English that Sanskrit's importance got reduced. The medium of English slowly changed for the elite also from Sanskrit or any pan-Indian language. But today, the interest in Sanskrit has got revived only because now, in a manner of speaking, we are going back in time, and therefore there is now a revival of interest in those texts, and therefore the more interest in Sanskrit also. And I'm quite sure learning and teaching of Sanskrit will be encouraged. Thank you very much.
Sri V. Krishnaswamy Iyer wanted the future generation to study Sanskrit and to also appreciate the great tradition of our country. And therefore, he founded this college in 1906. He achieved so much within just 4 decades and more of his life. He did not even live to be 50. But there was not one aspect of human life that he has not touched and enriched. Two great sons of India, Mahatma Gandhi and Gurudev Tagore, have visited this institution and have expressed their deep admiration for this institution as well as our founder.
Asmagam Bharata Bhumihi, Punya Bhumihi, Pavitra Bhumihi, Veda, Shastra, Vedanga, Purana, Itihasa, Adi, Jivana Shastra Visheshu, बद्धश्रद्धाः भारतीयाः तस्मात् संस्कृतरक्षणेनैव संस्कृतरक्षणं भवति तदर्थम् अस्मत् मद्रपुरी संस्कृतकलाशाला अनवरतं प्रयत्नं करोति
वेदाः चत्वारस्सन्ति नानाविधशाखाभिः उपेतास्सन्ति तैः मानवजीवनस्य साफल्याय ये उपायाः लौकिकैः प्रमाणैः अवगन्तुम् अशक्याः ते ज्ञाप्यन्ते वेदस्य मात्रा मात्रस्यापि यथा संरक्षणं सम्यक् भवेत् एतदर्थम् अस्माकं पूर्वजाः महर्षयः बहुविधान् ग्रन्थान् विरचय्य तत् संरक्षणं कारयामासुः तत्तन् महर्षिभिः 6 अङ्गानि प्रणीतानि सन्ति तानि अङ्गानि भवन्ति शिक्षा व्याकरणं छन्दः निरुक्तं ज्योतिषं तथा कल्पः
वी आर टेकिंग दिस वीडियो just to give you an idea about what we do at the Madras Sanskrit College. Now, this is an institution with a tremendous heritage. We have a reputation all over the country as a center for excellence in Sanskrit. Our teachers from this school are held in the highest reputation all over the country. Our past students hold very high positions in many institutions, both across the country and across the world. Now we are at a point where we want to spread our wings into the digital world. Please visit our website and see what we are doing. Thank you.
That was a short audio visual introducing the tradition and heritage of Madras Sanskrit College. Harihar Mahodaya, Bhavani Danim screen share kartum shaknati.
Namaskaraha.
Namo namaha.
Sarvadu yatra antarjala madhyamena upasthita santi sarvebhyah hardika swatantriya divasasya shubhabhisham janani nivedayitum icchami. Thank you.
Vaktavyam va kimapi madhya agantavyam va nama yadi avashyakam chet prachate
apeksha anusaram yathechcham agamyatam kripaya
avashyam
madhye kashchana klesha kimapi pratipadane asti ched aham bhavantam ahvayami
avashyam
tadanimapi bhavan kripaya agatya kinchit spashti karotu mama abhipraya
astu tathaiva bhavatu kinchit tatra clarity kinchit nyunataram asti kimartham na jane
tatha va
ha दर्शने किञ्चित् रेसोल्यूशन् न्यूनम् इति भासते क्लारिटि अस्तु समस्या नास्ति अग्रे गच्छतु भोः इदानीं किमपि वर्धितं रेसोल्यूशन् पुनः जातम् अस्तु अस्तु
फस्ट् आफ् आल् थेङ्क् यू मिस्टर् उदय श्रेयस् फार् the wonderful introduction and thanks for having me live in the Sanskrit channel. I wholeheartedly congratulate and salute Mr. Uday Shreyas for the yeoman service he does for the Sanskrit language and our Indian tradition. And happy Independence Day to all connected with us, and happy Independence Day to all who are going to watch this video later. Now with Mr. Uday's permission, I would like to share my screen. Share kartum shakyate kila?
Avashyam, avashyam. Yadi kleshah asti tarhi uchyatam.
Avashyam. दृश्यते वा
सम्यक्
अत्र मद्रपुरी संस्कृतमहाविद्यालयद्वारा अत्र आन्लैन् माध्यमेन डिजिटल् केम्पस् द्वारा ये ये पाठ्यक्रमाः प्रचाल्यन्ते तेषां विषये कश्चन परिचयः दातव्यः इति अत्र अहम् उपस्थितः अस्मि ऐ वुड् लैक् टु गिव् अ रोड् मेप् आन् आल् दि कोर्सस् दट् वि आफर् in the digital campus. Now I start with Sanskrita Praveshika. Sanskrita Praveshika 1 and Sanskrita Praveshika 2.
Mahodaya, you can make it full screen or from you can present it.
One minute.
I'm guessing you wanted to go to the next slide.
Drishyate eva idanim?
Na. Prathama slide eva drishyate itopi. Ha, idanim dvitiyam drishyate.
Okay. So, is it visible now?
The second one is visible.
Okay.
But it's still, is the full screen not working?
It is full screen for me. One minute.
Oh, okay.
I will do one thing. Okay. Is it good now?
One second. Maybe something is happening. No, still the entire
okay.
not sure, but the second slide is visible, but then your entire PPT is visible, not just the slide.
Okay. 1 minute, I will do one thing. I will share my entire screen instead of one window.
You just shared that window. Yeah. Anyat kimapi asti va? Yad na drashtavyam. Confidential stuff.
Tatha kimapi asti. इदानीं दृश्यते वा?
इदानीं द्वितीयः स्लाइड् दृश्यते, परन्तु इदानीं इदानीं सम्यक् अस्ति भोः. प्रथमं दृश्यते इदानीं. अग्रे गच्छतु किञ्चित्. इदानीं सर्वं सम्यक् अस्ति.
ओके. अहं संस्कृतेन वक्तुं शक्नोमि, भवान् ट्रान्स्लेट् करोति वा? आङ्ग्लमाध्यमेन किञ्चित् प्रयत्नं करोमि वा?
भवान् करोतु, यदि यत्र कुत्रापि मया आगन्तव्यं मध्ये.
धन्यवादः. सो संस्कृतप्रवेशिका 1 is our preliminary course, which we call basic course. Samskrita Praveshika 1 is for beginners. So in Samskrita Praveshika 1, we start from Aksharani.
Oh.
And the objective of Samskrita Praveshika 1 is to make the students understand some simple sentences. At the end of Samskrita Praveshika 1, the students will also be able to form errorless simple sentences.
Wonderful.
So in Samskrita Praveshika 1, we start with Aksharani. We introduce some simple nouns, and some vibhaktis are taught there, and five tenses, which are past, present, future, lat, lang, lit, and order, request, lot, vidhiling, lakaras are taught there.
Okay.
And some indeclinables, avyayani, are taught there. Like that, in Samskrita Praveshika 1, students will be able to parse the sentence, parse the words from a simple sentence.
Mm.
And from there, we will take the students to Samskrita Praveshika 2.
Okay.
In Samskrita Praveshika 2, some advanced grammatic concepts are taught there, like Sandhayaha, Samasaha, Sandhayaha, which we call conjugations. If I'm not right, please correct me, Mr. Uday.
No.
And compound words, Samasaha, are taught there. And we will also give a glimpse on poetic literature of Sanskrit. Some basic shlokas are taught there. For example, we teach some few verses of Valmiki Ramayanam and Bhagavad Gita there in Samskrita Praveshika 2. And we will also teach how to crack meaning from a shloka.
Hmm.
So Anvaya Prakriya is taught there.
Hmm.
How to do akanksha, ask questions using the verb, and how to order the jumbled words in the from the verse, from the Samskrita shloka.
Hmm.
So Samskrita Praveshika 2 and Samskrita Praveshika 1 put together are equivalent to certificate course.
Okay.
Samskrita Praveshika 1 and 2 are decided based on the certificate course that we offer part-time Saturdays and Sundays in the college premises.
Okay.
We designed the Samskrita Praveshika 1 and 2 based on that.
Okay.
So in order to join Samskrita Praveshika 1 or Samskrita Praveshika 2, students no need to have any prior knowledge in Sanskrit at all.
Wonderful.
So from Aksharani you can join. And of course, Samskrita Praveshika 1 has two versions. Self-paced version, where recorded videos will be there in our learning platform.
Mm-hmm.
At the end of every video, students have a quiz, post-lesson quiz.
Mm.
And they answer the quiz, click submit, the next lesson will be unlocked.
Beautiful.
Like this, they can go through all the lessons. There are 36 lessons in Samskrita Praveshika 1.
Mm-hmm.
This is self-paced version I'm talking about.
Okay.
And there is one another version, interactive version.
Mm-hmm.
this is not self-paced. In self-paced version, people, you know, log in at their own convenience and view the lessons and go through the worksheets and quiz and everything.
Got it.
But in interactive version, teacher will be present. It is happening. The inaugural batch is going on right now.
Oh.
As we speak now, there must be a class going on right now, actually.
Okay.
Mrs. Charulata, a scholar from Samskrita Kalashala, is teaching that.
Okay.
And the interactive version of Samskrita Praveshika 1 is for 3 months.
Okay.
There are 36 modules, right, in Samskrita Praveshika 1.
Mm-hmm.
So in the interactive version, we have 36 sessions.
Hmm.
Each session for 1 hour will be happening 6 p.m. to 7 p.m. IST on Wednesdays, Fridays and Sundays.
Wonderful.
For now, we don't have any parallel batches. So okay. People cannot subscribe for that interactive version right now.
Okay.
Since this batch that is going on is an inaugural batch, we are planning on making parallel batches, and we are also planning to cater different time zones and all.
Mm.
So very soon we will have parallel batches or different batches in the interactive version also.
Wonderful.
So Samskrita Praveshika 1 has interactive version, but Samskrita Praveshika 2, all other courses that I'm going to introduce are self-based only.
Okay. And I will leave links to all these, how to access these or how to get that self-paced version, the app, the website, sure. Wherever they can register. I'll leave it in the descriptions.
Sure.
Any age limit for these, Hariharanji, do you recommend?
Since these two courses Samskrita Praveshika 1 and 2 are taught in English medium, anyone who can understand English can join, can subscribe themselves to Samskrita Praveshika 1. So as you can see here, the medium of instruction will be in English.
Got it.
And Samskrita Praveshika 1 and 2.
Got it.
And those who wish to have at the end of Samskrita Praveshika 1 and 2, we have exam. Students will have a exam button activated once they finish the final lesson.
Oh, okay.
So a timer will be on, and then they have to answer some multiple choice question, objective type questions.
Kati prashnaha bhavanti tatra?
Saptati prashnaha bhavanti.
Oh, okay.
70 questions will be there.
Yes.
And once they answer all those questions and click submit, the result will be mailed
okay.
to them, and a downloadable certificate will be generated.
Oh, wow, nice.
This certificate is offered from college.
Hmm.
So I was talking about these two courses are based on certificate course, right? Part-time yes. course. Oh, so right, right. Those who wish to have a university certificate,
mm-hmm.
they have to study two more texts apart from Samskrita Praveshika 1 and 2.
Okay.
They have to go through Karnabharam of Bhasa.
Uh-huh.
Karnabharam is a play written by Kavi Bhasa. And first 5 stories of Hitopadesha.
Wow. Okay.
And they can register themselves in the college, and they have to write a university exam at the month of April.
Mm-hmm.
And then they can have a university certificate.
Okay. Is this a prerequisite for the next courses that are going to come up? Or?
Yes. Okay. Yes. The next course is Samskrita Dakshata. Samskrita Dakshata comes in 3 parts. Samskrita Dakshata is nothing different than diploma course offered part-time in the Sanskrit college premises.
Okay.
So diploma course and certificate course are part-time courses, as I said before.
Hmm.
Diploma course is conducted in the college campus itself on Saturdays and Sundays. Hmm. So Samskrita Dakshata comes in 3 parts, Samskrita Dakshata 1, 2 and 3.
Mm-hmm.
These Samskrita Dakshata courses are taught in Sanskrit language. Sanskrit medium of instruction will be Sanskrit.
Hmm.
So those who have done Sanskrita Praveshika 1 and 2 mm-hmm. will be able to understand or should be able to understand something taught in Sanskrit. Mm. So they are, of course, eligible to subscribe for Sanskrita Dakshata courses.
Got it.
So it is equivalent to diploma in Sanskritam. Mm. So if the students wish to have diploma itself, as I said before, they have to register themselves in the college premises and they have to come here and write the university exam at the month of April. Mm. And then they can have diploma in Sanskrit. And not only Sanskrita Praveshika 1 and 2 put together is the are the prerequisite for Sanskrita Dakshata. Mm-hmm. Those who have completed minimum 3 exams
okay.
in reputed Sanskrit institutions,
okay.
Such as Sanskrita Bharati,
mm-hmm.
Bharati Vidya Bhavan,
mm.
or Chittur Sanskrita Bhasha Pracharani Sabha,
mm.
Any reputed Sanskrit institutions, minimum 3 exams.
Mm.
Those who have passed the minimum 3 exams can enroll themselves in diploma wow. Sanskrit.
Got it.
So they will be able to understand something taught in Sanskrit, mm. right? So they can subscribe for Sanskrita Dakshata and learn it online, or they can register themselves for diploma in Sanskrit Avagatam. In the college premises.
Avagatam. So in order to do this diploma or this Dakshata courses, it's yes. not necessary that one must have gone through Praveshika only.
No, no need.
If they have enough proof that they have that skill from other yes. passing other exams from other institutes, even then they can apply for Dakshata directly.
Yes, yes.
Got
yes.
it.
College certificate will be given at the end of Sanskrita Dakshata 3.
Mm-hmm.
And if the students write the exam in the month of April, they can have university certificate also.
Wonderful.
Okay, then we have Prak Shiromani launching. It's Prak Shiromani courses and the next course is Sanskrita Shiromani BA. Mm-hmm. BA course. Online versions are launched right now.
Mahodaya, atra ekah prashnah.
Please.
And for others also, guys, if you have any questions, please don't type it in chat. You can ask a question in that ask a question section below. And others, if you have the same question, you can upvote it, downvote it. Then we'll be able to, Hariharanji will be able to address all of them, or at least the first few of them when the time comes. So please don't put it in chat. We might not be able to look at it. And Mahodaya, bhavatah krite, tatra dakshata 3 iti course asti kalu. Atra tasya ante, at the end of Dakshata 3, what is the skill expected that one can expect?
Tat samichinaha ayam prashnaha. Samskrita Dakshata Pathyakramam samapitavatam chatranam samskrita kavyani yani santi tani swataha te avagantum shaknuvanti.
Dakshata prapnuvanti.
Dakshatam prapnuti. Atra in Sanskrit, the Samskrita Dakshata courses, I think it would be better if I read out the syllabus of Sanskrita Dakshata course.
Okay.
In Sanskrita Dakshata, we have 50 verses of Bhartrihari's Niti Shatakam
mm-hmm.
and 15th Panchadasha Sarga of Sundara Kandam of Valmiki Ramayanam.
Okay.
And 4th act of Abhijnana Shakuntalam written by none other than Kalidasa. And 5th act of Swapna Vasavadattam written by Bhasakavi and Laghu Kadambari Sangraha is there. These are the texts taught in Sanskrita Dakshata. So students will have practice of how to understand different kavis shlokas. So to give
Parichaya.
yes Shaili Parichaya Vibhinna Kavinam शैलीनां परिचयः दातव्यः इति एवं रूपेण अयं पाठ्यक्रमः निर्मितः वर्तते
सुन्दरम्
अवगतम् अग्रे गच्छामि वा
अवश्यं
संस्कृत प्राक्षुरमणि कोर्स इस् देर् मीडियम् आफ् टीचिङ्ग् विल् बि इन् संस्कृत ओन्ली सो दोस् हू हाव् डन् संस्कृत दक्षता विल् बि एलिजिबल् फार् प्राक्षुरमणि आर् दोस् हू केन् understand Sanskrit well, those who have completed SSLC are eligible for this course. So Samskrita Prak Shiromani is offered online for now. We have launched the online version. This will be a hybrid course, like interactive versions, interactive sessions will be there. We have 5 papers in Prak Shiromani. Prak Shiromani course is a university offered course.
Okay.
So it comes in 4 semesters.
Okay.
Sanskrit Prak Shiromani is a foundation course, as you can see in the slide itself. Mm. So 4 semesters are there. 3 Sanskrit subjects papers will be there, and 2 language papers will be there. Those who have a degree already, like BA in engineering or BA in arts, some bachelor's degree. Those who can, those people can opt out of language papers, like Hindi and English or Tamil optional is there. They can opt out of the language subjects, and they can just focus on Sanskrit lessons. So Samskrita Prak Shiromani, there are 4 semesters, as I said before. The people who are willing to get the certificate from the university should come to the college or to the center to write the university exam every 6 months.
Wow. There is on Madras Sanskrit College YouTube channel, there is one Madanji who was asking, I live in Melbourne.
Okay.
Could I do these exams online? I guess for Prak Shiromani, no.
Yes, online exams will be there, but university certificate will not be available for those who
write it online.
Write it online.
Got it.
So having done the online, having finished the online course, they can have college certificate.
Hmm.
So in order to get the university certificate, students have to come to the center and write the examinations for every 6 months.
Understood.
Prak Shiromani. Prak Shiromani courses like this.
In Madras, in Chennai.
In Chennai.
Okay.
And we have Samskrita Shiromani hi Madhyama. We say BA, Madhyama for BA, Acharya for MA.
Got it.
So there are 6 departments in our college. Sahitya, Vyakaranam, Vedantaha, Nyayaha, Mimamsa, and Jyotisha Shastram is there. For online version, we have Sahitya alone.
Oh, okay.
Sahitya Shastram is Alankara Shastram.
Hmm.
I think it would be better if you can explain a few words about Alankara Shastram.
Oh.
Can you take it?
I don't know exactly what is offered or what is not, but Sahitya, it comes from Saha. So the sound along with meaning. Sahitya, it's Rahitya is the opposite of Sahitya. So if there is no connection between sound and meaning, it is Artha Rahityam va, Shabda Arthanam Paraspara Sanyoga Rahityam va, Kimapi Vaktum Shaknumaha. So Sahitya, roughly, very base translation in English can be literature. I guess that is why you guys have offered only that online, and these other fields of study, be it Mimamsa, Nyaya, or Vyakarana, even Vyakarana, people think it's just grammar, but these are all just disciplines of study. And as we have seen in the audiovisual, introductory audiovisual, the way Madras Sanskrit College approaches these teaching methodologies is very rooted in tradition, that there is a teacher sitting in and there is this guru shishya parampara, this transmission kind of a thing happening. So I guess it is apt that only Sahitya or literature of it is presented.
We can say literature for now, but Alankara Shastram is about understanding the nuances of kavyams, like
Astu. Alankara Shastra Vishaya kim chit vaktavyam va maya
kinchit uchyate chet samyak bhavati no chet ante pashyami
astu
apeksha anusaram
astu.
This Samskrita Shiromani BA course, Sahitya department alone is available on online for now.
Mm-hmm.
We are planning on making available the other shastrams also in future.
You are. Okay.
So this also will be a hybrid course, like interactive sessions will be there. For each and every paper, an expert will be there online in a particular time, and students have to come online. And the sessions will be more like orientation, interactive sessions. So recorded videos will be there in the login. Students can go through the videos and learn at their own pace. But if they have any questions that they need any doubt clearance or anything like that, they can attend the interactive sessions and learn that. So
it is sarve Zoom madhyamena bhavanti prayah khalu
prayena Zoom madhyamena
astu
anantaram yatha purvam niveditam asit prakshuramani pathyakrama iva ayamapi pathyakramah semester pattern madhye agacchati
evam
arthat prati prati masa shatkam shanmasottaram prati paryayam agatya atra pariksha lekhaniya bhavati विश्वविद्यालयस्य यूनिवर्सिटि आफ् मद्रास् अफिलियेटेड् अस्ति अस्माकं कलाशाला अतः
ततः एव ध्रुवपत्रमपि लभ्यते
एवमेवं मासात् पूर्वमेव तत्र यूनिवर्सिटि मध्ये परीक्षादिनाङ्कादिकं लभ्यते टैम् टेबल्स् सर्वं लभ्यते तदनुसारं ये विदेशीयाः अपि ते तत्र वीसा इत्यादिकं स्वीकृत्य तदनुसारम् आगत्य परीक्षादिकम्
एतत् सर्वम् आङ्ग्लमाध्यमे अपि वक्तव्यं प्रायः
There are people
from abroad who are coming with applying visas and everything, and because this also has the same format of examinations every 6 months which have to be taken in person, so there are apparently as expected, of course, not a surprise, that people who are coming from abroad to write to attend these exams, and dates are announced by the University of Madras, and even the certificate is given by the University of Madras.
अग्रे गच्छामि वा
अवश्यं भोः
अनन्तरं तर्कसङ्ग्रहः इति तर्कसङ्ग्रहग्रन्थमाधारीकृत्य एकः पाठ्यक्रमः निर्मितः अस्ति तर्कशास्त्रम् अस्माकं भारतीयदर्शनेषु न्यायवैशेषिकदर्शनयोः मेलनेन तर्कशास्त्रम् इति वदामः तत्र आङ्ग्लभाषायां कथं वक्तव्यं
logical reasoning iti vaktum shaknum
vaktum shakyate logical reasoning in indic
thought process
yes tarka sangraha pathyakramah self paced vartate sanskrita bhasha madhyamena bhavishyati atah etavat sanskrita dakshata pathyakramam samapitavantah te atra sakshat tarka sangraham kevalam ayam granthah eva adhyetavyah vastutah ekamasti atra purvam maya prakshiromani पाठ्यक्रमः प्रदर्शितः किल इन् दिस् प्राक्षिरोमिनि सिलबस् इट् सेल्फ् तर्कसङ्ग्रहः कम्स् अस् ओन् पेपर्
ओके
इट् कम्स् इन् थर्ड् सेमेस्टर् प्राक्षिरोमिणि सो दोस् हू आर् विल्लिङ्ग् टु लर्न् तर्कसङ्ग्रहः दि टेक्स्ट् अलोन् केन् आप्ट् फार् दिस् कोर्स् अण्ड् दे केन् सब्स्क्रैब् फार् दिस् तर्कसङ्ग्रह कोर्स् I have recorded the video sessions of Tarka Sangraha course, so recorded videos, self-paced learning, students can log in at their own convenience and go through the lessons.
Got it. More people are asking how to register. Guys, I'll put the links in the description later on, people on YouTube. And of course, Hariharanji will be presenting all those methods also in a few slides.
Yes, so at the end of the presentation, I will give the details.
Yes.
And Laghu Siddhanta Kaumudi course is there.
Okay.
In Prakshuromani course also, Laghu Siddhanta Kaumudi is partially available.
Okay.
Like Panchasandhi Prakaranam alone is available from Laghu Siddhanta Kaumudi. Laghu Siddhanta Kaumudi is a Prakarana Grantham. Prakarana Granthaha for Sanskrita Vyakaranam. Prakarana Granthasya Vishaye Kim Vaktavyam. A preliminary text.
Oh, perfect. That's wonderful.
To enter into Sanskrita Paninian grammar.
Yeah.
So there is a Vyakarana Siddhanta Kaumudi text written by Bhattoji Dikshita. Laghu Siddhanta Kaumudi is a short version of Siddhanta Kaumudi written by Varadarajacharya. So Laghu Siddhanta Kaumudi course is there. This Laghu Siddhanta Kaumudi course is in Sanskrit medium. Mm-hmm. And Laghu Siddhanta Kaumudi course is actually a recording of a workshop.
Okay.
Which took part in the college premises. Mm-hmm. The year 2018, I think. Yes.
Okay.
So, please.
Got it. So that was what I mean. I thought I'll keep it for later, but whatever sessions are being done in the campus, in the college, they are recorded and they are kept for later review as well. Because I see this happening in multiple IITs, and so that they don't have to repeat it. It's whatever is being taught by any particular professor to the batch is available for public to watch at a later time, and it is converted into courses. This happens in MIT as well. So it's wonderful that, and this was lacking in our institutions, in the institutions this was not there, but it's wonderful to see again that that this institute is doing it.
And in Laghu Siddhanta Kaumudi, 10 scholars from all around India have visited and took the sessions. Wonderful. So those sessions are recorded and we have it as a course. Online.
Perfect.
So this is also a self-paced course. Recorded video lessons will be there.
Okay.
And at the end of the course, a college certificate is added.
And to register for this Laghu Siddhanta Kaumudi course, are the other prerequisites there still?
Yes, yes. Sanskrit Dakshata.
Dakshata Apekshate.
Yes, Dakshata is prerequisite. As I said before, those who have done at least three level exams in repeated, basically those who can understand something taught in Sanskrit.
Got it.
They can enroll themselves in Tarka Sangraha straight away, or the Laghu Siddhanta Kaumudi, or in Dakshata courses itself. Dakshata courses are about kavyams. Got only it. Kavyams are taught there with Vyakarana Visheshas. Vilakshanaha Kashchana Prayogaha Vartate. अत्र कः प्रत्ययः कः व्याकरणविशेषः अस्ति इत्यादिकं मध्ये अपेक्षानुसारं दक्षता पाठ्यक्रमे पाठ्यते. लघुसिद्धान्तकौमुदी पाठ्यक्रमे तावत् व्याकरणमेव पाठ्यते. तर्कसङ्ग्रहपाठ्यक्रमे तर्कशास्त्रमेव, पङ्क्तिसमन्वयः इति उच्यते किल, तत्र पङ्क्तीनां पठनं सामान्यतः अर्थः उक्तः वर्तते. तर्कसङ्ग्रहपाठ्यक्रमम् अहमेव कृतवान्. तत्र 30 पाठाः भवन्ति, प्रतिपाठं सामान्यतः अर्धघण्टाकालः भवति. संस्कृतप्रवेशिका 1 वर्तते किल,
सत्यं,
तत्र सामान्यतः 1 वीडियो रेकार्डिङ्ग् एवरेज् आफ् वीडियो विल् बी लैक् 12-15 मिनिट्स् लैक्
दट्. तावदेव
तावदेव तत्र आरम्भपाठे अत्यन्तं लघु वीडियो सेव अस्माभिः क्रियते. किमर्थम् इत्युक्तौ
मयापि तदेव क्रियते.
कः क्लेशः इत्युक्तौ, एतावत् आन्लैन् माध्यमेन पिपठिषन्ति, तेषाम् अटेन्शन् स्पेन् बहु न्यूनं भवति.
सत्यं.
किञ्चित् वीडियो पश्यन्ति, पास् कृत्वा अन्यत्र गत्वा अन्यदर टैब ओपन कृत्वा किमपि कार्यं समाप्य पुनः आगच्छन्ति. एवं रीत्या
5 निमेषात् पूर्वं यदुक्तं तद् विस्मरामि.
अतः अटेंशन स्पैन प्रेक्षकाणां तदनुसारं आरम्भपाठाः अत्यन्तं लघुपाठाः एव कृताः. ग्रेजुअली इन्क्रीस् कुर्मः. प्रवेशिका 2 मध्ये 20 मिनिट्स् एवरेज् भवति प्रति वीडियो. अनन्तरं दक्षता पाठ्यक्रमे 30 मिनिट्स् एवरेज् भवति. तर्क अत्यन्तं ये जिज्ञासवः वर्तन्ते ते युगपत् वीडियो द्वयं त्रयम् अपि समापयितुं शक्नुवन्ति.
सत्यं.
किन्तु अस्माकं फोकस् तावत् अत्यन्तं सामान्यछात्राः. अतः अहं सामान्यतः इदं वदामि, मादृशः छात्रः एव मया
चिन्त्यते
पाठनकाले. व्युत्पन्नस्य कृते पाठयित्वा तथा महत् प्रयोजनं न भवति. ते कथञ्चित् पठितुं शक्नुवन्ति स्वतः.
सत्यम्.
अतः मादृशः छात्रः मया मनसि क्रियते.
तदर्थमेव अहमपि आङ्ग्लमाध्यमेन एव वक्तुं वदन् अस्मि.
आरम्भे तथा क्रियते.
अवगतम्.
सम्यक्. अनन्तरं वेदान्तदक्षता पाठ्यक्रमः वर्तते. अत्र त्रयः
अष्टाध्यायी न पाठ्यते वा
अष्टाध्यायी पाठ अष्टाध्यायी क्रमेण नास्ति लघुसिद्धान्तकौमुदी पाठ्यक्रमे सूत्राणामेव अर्थवर्णनं भवति किन्तु अष्टाध्यायी स्थानी सर्वाणि सूत्राणि लघुसिद्धान्तकौमुदो वा वस्तुतः सिद्धान्तकौमुद्यामपि नास्ति भट्टोजीदीक्षितविरचितः ग्रन्थः वर्तते किल सिद्धान्तकौमुदी तत्र प्रायेण वदन्ति विरलविरलाणि सूत्राणि त्यक्तानि सन्ति सामान्यतः अष्टाध्यायी सूत्राणि सर्वाण्यपि तत्र सन्ति इति तस्य लघु अंशः लघुरूपं भवति लघुसिद्धान्तकौमुदी
सत्यं
सिद्धान्तकौमुद्याः लघुरूपं
सत्यं
अतः तावन्ति सूत्राणि न भवन्ति अष्टाध्यायी सूत्रक्रमेण सूत्रार्थः ज्ञातव्यश्चेत् काशिकाक्रमेण अस्माभिः ज्ञातव्यः
सत्यं सत्यं
कुतः अत्र भवान् जानाति इति मन्ये अष्टाध्यायी सूत्रपाठक्रमेण काशिका
केवलम् एवमेव पृष्टं मया किमर्थम् इत्युक्ते अन्ये शिक्षकाः लघुसिद्धान्ती सिद्धान्तकौमुद्याः अनन्तरम् अष्टाध्याय्यां नयन्ति छात्रान् तदर्थम् एवमेव पृष्टं
तत् कर्तुं शक्यते लघुसिद्धान्तकौमुदीं ये पठितवन्तः तेषां सामान्यतः काशिकाक्रमेण अष्टाध्यायीक्रमेण पाठः सम्भवति ते पठितुं शक्नुवन्ति किन्तु अस्माकं कोर्सस् मध्ये
इतोपि न निर्मितं
समीचीनं काशिकाक्रमेण एकः पाठ्यक्रमः योजयितुमपि शक्यते कदाचित् भाविकाले अस्माकं प्लान्स् तु अस्ति बहु दशगणी सिद्धान्तकौमुदीरीत्या केवलं दश लकाराः सन्ति किल दशगणाः च सन्ति
सत्यं
धातुपाठक्रमः दशगणी पाठ्यक्रमः एकः निर्मातव्यः इति
उत्तमम् अहं
रीत्या
पञ्जीकरणम्
अवश्यम् अनन्तरं वेदान्तदक्षतापाठ्यक्रमः वेदान्तदक्षतापाठ्यक्रमे त्रयः महापण्डिताः इदं पाठ्यक्रमं पाठयित्वा समापितवन्तः महामहोपाध्यायः अस्माकं गुरुचरणाः ब्रह्मश्रीमणिद्राविडाचार्याः तत्र तोटकाष्टकं दक्षिणामूर्ति अष्टकम् इदं द्वयमपि पाठितवन्तः डाक्टर् के एस् महेश्वरन् नम्बूदिरी महोदयः महान्तः अद्वैतपण्डिताः ते वेदान्तसार इति नाम्ना एकः ग्रन्थः वर्तते तं ग्रन्थं पाठितवन्तः अनन्तरं वासुदेवन् नम्बूदिरी इति कश्चन महोदयः महान् पण्डितः मम अपि सुहृद्वर्यः सः गीतायां प्रथमाध्यायं पाठितवान् इति दक्षतायां पाठ्यक्रमः अयं वर्तते दिस् इस् अ प्रिलिमिनरी कोर्स् फार् अद्वैतवेदान्त वेदान्तदक्षता इति नाम यद्यपि अस्ति किन्तु अद्वैतवेदान्तः एव अत्र पाठ्यते
इदानीमेव मया स्मर्यते यथा अन्वेषयन् आसं दक्षता इत्यस्य पदस्य किम् आङ्ग्लपरिवर्तनम् आङ्ग्ल अनुवादं किं भवितुम् अर्हति इति डेक्स्टरिटी समहौ सौण्ड्स् वेरि क्लोज् दक्षता बै सौण्ड् सो डेक्स्टरिटि इन् वेदान्त देर् आर् दीस् कोर्सेस् विच् आर् आफर्ड् अण्ड् डेक्स्टरिटि इन् साहित्य देर् वेर् अदर्स् विच् महोदय मेन्शन् बिफोर् जस्ट् एस् अ सैड् नोट्
ओके वेदान्ते एव इतोपि अन्ये केचन पाठ्यक्रमाः सङ्कल्पे नाम इदानीं कार्याणि तदर्थम् आरम्भणीयानि सन्ति तत्र उपरि वेदान्तदक्षताम् अतिरिच्य अग्रेपि पाठ्यक्रमादिकं निर्मातव्यम् इति अस्ति अस्माकम् अनन्तरं पञ्चाङ्गं कोर्स् तमिळ् कोर्स् इस् देर् तिथिवारनक्षत्रयोगकरण इति पञ्चाङ्गानि दैनन्दिनव्यवहारे अस्माकं वर्तते तत्र तिथिः नाम एतावत्कालपर्यन्तं वर्तते मध्याह्नोत्तरम् अन्या तिथिः आरभ्यते नक्षत्रम् एतादृशनाडिकापर्यन्तम् अद्य वर्तते अद्य विशाखानक्षत्रं चेत् मध्याह्नपर्यन्तं वर्तते अनन्तरं विशाखानक्षत्रं समाप्य अग्रिमम् आरभ्यते इति अत्र मूलं किं किमर्थम् एवं परिवर्तनमस्ति इत्यादि विषयाः अत्र ज्योतिषपण्डितः अध्यापकः अस्माकं कलाशालीयः ममापि सुहृद्वर्यः वर्तते मुरलीमहोदयः सः पाठितवान्
एवम्
अयं पाठ्यक्रमः तमिळ्भाषायां भवति न केवलं पञ्चाङ्गानि तदतिरिच्यापि राहुकालविषये पञ्चाङ्गस्य आधारेण ये कालोपाधयः निर्णीयन्ते यथा राहुकाल यमगण्डादिकं तद्विषयेपि अत्र पाठाः भवन्ति. पञ्चाङ्गं कोर्स् समाप्तौ अपि at the end of the panchangam course also there is a simple exam and finishing the exam they can get a certificate.
Okay,
so panchangam course tamil course vartate. Anantaram yoga praveshika.
Okay.
Yoga praveshika course and the next course is hatha yoga sangraha.
Oh.
These two courses are designed with collaboration of krishnamachari yoga mandiram.
Okay,
so teachers from krishnamachari yoga mandiram they have designed this yoga praveshika. Yoga praveshika is a preliminary course, the basic course for yoga.
Mm-hmm.
So some asanas are also taught there, but mainly they teach what is ashtanga yoga.
Mm-hmm.
Yama niyama asana. Mm-hmm. All that. So you can I think it is not, it will not be good if I explain about yoga praveshika or hatha yoga sangraha.
Sure.
These courses are available in our site and people can go there and check out the description.
Sure.
About these courses. So hatha yoga sangraha is the next level course in yoga that we offer online. Hatha yoga sangraha is based on hatha yoga pradipika.
Got it.
So hatha yoga sangraha is also there. Former director of Krishnamachari Yoga Mandiram took the classes and pre-recorded lessons are there. So this course is also self-paced. So in order to join Yoga Praveshika and Hatha Yoga Sangraha, in order to join Hatha Yoga Sangraha, one must have completed Yoga Praveshika.
Hmm.
In order to join Yoga Praveshika, there is no prerequisite, I think. People who can understand English, I can join Yoga Praveshika straight away.
Got it.
And Hatha Yoga Sangraha is also there. So to understand Hatha Yoga Sangraha, one can finish the Yoga Praveshika. Only 9 lessons are there, 9 videos. And finishing those videos, they can subscribe themselves to Hatha Yoga Sangraha.
Got it.
And I have not added the mobile apps that we have in the presentation.
Mm-hmm.
But I would like to point out right now that we have 2 mobile apps. One is for spoken Sanskrit.
Mm-hmm.
I will give the link for
yes.
Those 2 apps.
Yes, yes. You can
later.
Give me all the links. I'll place them in the description.
Sanskrita Samvadaha is there.
Mm-hmm.
Using that app, we can learn spoken Sanskrit.
Mm-hmm.
And Shloka A Day app is there.
Yeah.
Where one shloka is explained in 3 to 5 minutes of average.
Nice.
Every day. This is a daily update app.
Okay.
So those who have installed the app, and the explanation of those shlokas are in 3 languages for now.
Nice.
English, Hindi and Tamil.
Wonderful.
So once users install the app, they can select language and for each and every shloka posted, they will be notified.
Got it.
So one shloka a day people can learn.
Beautiful.
And simple shlokas like stotra pathas.
Mm-hmm.
Of Adi Shankaracharya or Vedanta Deshika.
Mm-hmm.
Are explained there, and some niti shlokas are also there.
Nice.
Subscribers can also, you know, request make a request.
Really?
Of yes, yes,
that's nice.
We will do those shlokas in future like that.
Beautiful. Okay. But how can they request, Mahodaya? How will they raise a request from the app?
From the app, they cannot do that. They can
write
to the college and we will respond to that.
Got it.
And I just wanted to, you know, share few words on our learning platform.
Mm-hmm.
So all the courses that I was talking about before are available in the learning platform, which is digital.madrassanskritcollege.edu.in. And one another learning platform is there. So
and somebody was asking about the fees for this, like what are the fees for.
Yes, they can check those.
They are mentioned in the platform itself.
Yes.
Against every course, is the fees for that particular course is mentioned.
Yes.
Got it.
So these learning platforms, there are two learning platforms we have. One is maintained by Classal Knowledge Private Limited. They are hosting our courses, and Samskrita College, we ourselves have another learning platform.
Okay.
So these two learning platforms are based on this principle. Acharyat Padam Adatte, Padam Shishyaha Swamedhaya, Padam Sabrahmacharibhya, Padam Kalakramena Cha. So it would be better if you explain, but if you want me to, I can try.
No, samasya nasti, aham karomi. Kinchit viramam nayatu bhavan api. Astu, aham karomi. So guys, Hariharanji wants to point out subtly that despite how much ever teachers or shikshakaah, acharyaah, paathakaah, how much ever they try to reach out and present so much content, so many lessons to the students, learning for oneself happens in four stages. It's not all upon one particular individual, either the student or the teacher. The responsibility is fourfold. It's from four different levels that once learning happens. One quarter of it, padam, is from acharya, the one who provides that knowledge. And the second quarter of it from, of course, from the student's own intellect, from the medha, swamedha of shishya. The next quarter is from sabrahmacharibhya, from the students around, from the group activities, from other people in the same pursuits, from, you know, learning and interacting and seeing how others learning is, and just interacting from other students. Another quarter learning happens within oneself. And the final quarter is through time, this time through repeated application by probably manana, or, you know, with time as you age, as that knowledge that you have grasped ages, it becomes more and more mature within you. These are the four levels of learning that he wanted to point out, that these are what encompass the entire learning experience of any particular chhatra.
Okay. Thank God that you took over to explain. So our learning platform is based on this principle. So for Acharya Padamadatte, as you explained, 1/4 of the knowledge is attained from Guru. So video lessons, quizzes are there. Ask an expert forum is there. So those who are learning online, they have doubts and all, right? So they can post their questions in Ask an Expert section. We will be responding to that. We will answer those questions. Some questions, you know, cannot be asked in text format, right? Some confirmative questions will be there. Some questions regarding pronunciation will be there. So for those kind of doubts or questions, we have Skype sessions. Nice. So on-demand Skype sessions are there from the beginning course. Even let it be Samskrita Praveshika or Vedanta Dakshata or whatever course, students can request a Skype session, and we can schedule a session, and we can clear their doubts.
Got.
So Skype session is there. And to give exposure, Padam Shishyaha Swamedhaya, from multiple sources, students may learn. For that, we have worksheets, free audio, video, and textbooks are there in the learning platform. These are all free contents. 99% of these contents are free only. So no need to subscribe for the course also. Even before subscribing to a course, students are those who have registered in our site can go through these free contents available. Mobile apps are there, and our YouTube channel is there.
Yes.
So they can improve whatever they learned by listening to these audio video books and going through the textbooks. And worksheets are there for practice. At the end of every lesson, Uday, students can download a worksheet and solve those worksheets.
Beautiful.
And we have some section called additional resources.
Okay.
Where we have uploaded the solved worksheet for all the lessons.
Oh, nice.
So they can correct these worksheets written by them themselves by referring to the additional resources section.
Got it.
And the third quarter of knowledge is attained by interacting with fellows, right? Padam Sabrahmacharibhya. So for that, we have two forums, which are called learning circles and course circles. So in the learning circles, students can interact with their fellows, like batchmates. So they can create a thread, like say they go through a similar subject in another channel, like they come, they go through a lesson in the Sanskrit channel. Mr. Uday will be teaching something like that. So they can start a discussion about that in the in this forum. They can create a thread and they can chat among themselves.
This is a wonderful idea. I'll of course feel free to rip off of some of your formats and how you're offering courses.
Please,
this is actually a wonderful, wonderful idea. I mean, of course, I keep getting these requests from students that, you know, but this is mostly around ye adhyatma vishaye kim api charcham kartum ichanti te vanchanti. So they want groups where Sri Vidya, we want to discuss with other practitioners. But this is a wonderful platform for group study kind of an activity.
इदानीं पश्यतु भवान् हितोपदेशं वा पञ्चतन्त्रं पाठयति किल
सत्यं
तत्र कश्चन विषयः तैः ज्ञातः शिष्यैः छात्रैः तत्र समानः विषयः अत्र पाठितः वर्तते इति चिन्तयामः तदाधारेण ते चर्चां कर्तुं शक्नुवन्ति अन्यत्र यूट्यूब् चानल् वा अन्यत्र यत्किञ्चित् प्लाट्फार्म् मध्ये
दिस् इस् एक्चुअली अ वेरी वेरी वैस् move by, and this is needed by the teachers to do. Discord iti namna bahavah platforms santi yatra this group kind of an activity is being streamlined so that they can save notes. I guess there are, we need, I definitely need to research it, but kutra bhoho etat sarvam ganah kutra
tatra te tavat once they subscribe to a course, say it is batch 60 of Sanskrita Praveshika 1. So if there are some 50 to 100 people there, so a learning circles menu will be there in their login itself.
Okay.
So they can go there and create a thread, or they can see threads that are created already and join discussion there.
And this is this, where is the, what is the platform? Is it Facebook or WhatsApp groups or on the app itself there is a separate?
अस्माकं सैट् मध्ये
इन्
अवर् सैट् इट् सेल्फ्
ओके
सो दि क्लासिकल् नालेज् प्रैवेट् सिस्टम् एस् ऐ
वाज़् टॉकिंग अबाउट यू सीम टु हैव अ रोबस्ट सिस्टम् व्हिच हैज ऑल ऑफ दिस यू सीम टु हैव अ गुड टेक्निकल बैक एंड फॉर ऑल ऑफ दिस
यस यस
वंडरफुल
ते समीचीनं कार्यं कृतवन्तः अस्माकं कोर्स सर्वं ते होस्ट् कुर्वन्ति प्रायेण तेषां सकाशात् इदं सर्वं क्रियते ते एव तत्र इदं कुर्वन्ति इदम् आस्क् एन् एक्स्पर्ट् मध्येपि टेक्निकल् इश्यूस् अपि छात्राः तत्र सूचयितुं शक्नुवन्ति से पीपल् नार्मलि दे से लैक् दि 11th लेसन् इस् नाट् गेटिङ्ग् रिलीस्ड् ऐ हेव् फिनिश्ड् दि क्विज् आफ् 10th लेसन् लैक् दट् टेक्निकल् इश्यूस् ते पोस्ट् कुर्वन्ति चेत् अहं फार्वर्ड् करोमि टेक्निकल् टीम् कृते क्लासिकल् नालेड्ज् प्रैवेट् सिस्टम् विल् टेक् इट् ओवर् फ्रम् देर् अण्ड् दे विल् इण्टराक्ट् वित् दि students via email
always,
and they can
it's always better to have somebody else taking care of the technical side. I know the pains of it.
yes And padam kalakramena chasti eva tatasya vivaranam kartum na shakyate samskarah eva asmakam krite kinchit patam nyapayati purnatam tadeva sampadayati kala
okay kala tasmin vishe
idam url asti asmakam
okay अहं स्थापयामि डिस्क्रिप्शन् मध्ये बट् गैस् इफ् यु वाण्ट् टु क्विक्लि चेक् औट् द वेब्सैट् अण्ड् द यु आर् एल् दट् इस् द यु आर् एल् दट् हस् बिन् टैप्ड् देर् ऐ थिङ्क् यस् वन् सेकेण्ड् लेट् मी टैप् इट् औट् इन् चाट् सर्वत्र दर्शन् पर्मार्जिस् इस् 0.01% किं तत् 0.01% अत्र यूट्यूब् मध्ये अपि स्थापयन् अस्मि ऐ एम् स्विचिङ्ग् द पिन्ड् कमेण्ट् फ्रम् the previous crowdcast link to this digital link. I guess I don't need to do that in your own YouTube channel, but still, if anybody is interested, you can, I've posted the link in all the three platforms, guys, you can check it out. Astu, समाप्तं वा श्रीमन्
धन्यवादाः अत्र विशेष धन्यवादार्हः भवान् एव
धन्यवादः अहं स्वीकरोमि मम किमपि लज्जा नास्ति धन्यवादः इट्स माय प्लेजर ऑफ कोर्स टू हैव यू गाइस and I hope some of the curiosity among my audiences has also been quelled and I hope this inspires and motivates more people and at least gives them an access to institutions of such national importance and who have been striving, as I said, through centuries to keep the knowledge and tradition alive. Of course, there are many, many other institutions, but looking at, of course, the technical expertise, even if they themselves are not experts, they have taken enough steps to make sure that all of this is available to as many people as possible, that the technical backend is as robust and that students don't face any technical issues, and all that has been taken care of. So thank you so much, Mahodaya, for your patient presentation of all the topics. Let us quickly look at Idanim. So we are slightly ahead of time, like we're 15 minutes beyond 1 hour. We'll take a couple of questions, guys. But if anybody is interested, if anybody wants to come on screen and ask a question, say if you have anything to say, you can let me know in the chat on Crowdcast and I can invite you up on screen. But now coming to questions. Somebody, Sai Kiranji said ancient science and technology and that has 5 upvotes. Guys, why? What is this? Somebody else with I have a name. Ayushji asked, sir, if you could discuss about the Varna Vichheda and pronunciation of the words Sanskrit and Simha. I'm confused about Anuswar. Guys, keep the questions relevant to Hariharanji. We'll respect his time and presence here. But still, you want to take this, Mahodaya? So they are somehow, despite repeated instruction, they are confused as to how to pronounce the bindu, and then after the bindu, the anunasika sound, how is it if it is followed by vyanjanani or consonants after the pavarga? Uh-huh. Until pavarga, it's clear for them that it has to be the anunasika sound at the end, but after pavarga, how is that anunasika swara pronounced? Is it ma or is it samskritam? Is it simhaha or is it sanskritam and simhaha?
Anunasika shabdaha samskritam iti bhavati. Vastataha uccharane samskritam iti vadamaha. Anunasikasya tatha hakim uchite uccharana idam asmabhi na
bhavati. Nasikam upayujyo uchite. Satyam tadeva vadami punah punah aham punah punah etadeva prashna.
Anuswarasya yayi parasavarnaha iti asti. कवर्गः चवर्गः वा तवर्गः तवर्गः पवर्गः च वर्गीयव्यञ्जनम् अनुस्वारस्य पृष्ठतः वर्तते चेत् सन्धिकाले वयं तत्तद्वर्गीयपञ्चमाक्षरम् उपयुज्य वदामः.
सत्यम्.
इदानीम् उदाहरणार्थं हिन्दीभाषायां गं गा इति लिखन्ति.
सत्यम्.
किन्तु गङ्गा इति उच्चारणं भवति.
सत्यम्.
कवर्गस्य पञ्चम अक्षरं
एवं पञ्चवर्गेषु अपि तथैव भवति रीतिः. अनन्तरं यरलव संयमः
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 संवरणं.
सत्यं. संवत्सरः
संवत्सरः.
तत्र वारं वारम् एतदेव प्रश्न, न जाने किमर्थमिति, परन्तु
अयं क्लेशः सामान्यतः तत्र इण्टराक्टिव् सेशन् ते एकवारम् उच्चार्य प्रदर्शयन्ति चेत्
सत्यं
परस्पर मेलनेन तत्
सत्यं सत्यं. धन्यवादः. ऐ होप् दट् आन्सर्ड् युर् क्वश्चन् आयुष् जी. बट् अगेन् इट्स् वेल् लेट्स् डू इट् इन् बाक्षी सेशन्स् वेन् वि डू इट्. वसुन्धरा जी आस्क्स्, ऐ गेस् दिस् इस् अ कामन् क्वश्चन् अगेन्, केरियर् आपर्चुनिटीस् आफ्टर् स्टडिङ्ग् संस्कृत, पर्टिक्युलर्ली आफ्टर् एम् ए इन् संस्कृत.
सामान्यतः संस्कृतं पठित्वा अध्यापयितुं शक्यते. प्रायेण ये संस्कृतं तावत् पठन्ति ते अध्यापनं कुर्वन्ति. किन्तु रिसर्च् मध्ये महान् अवकाशः वर्तते.
सत्यं.
ये संस्कृतं पठितवन्तः तत्र मेनुस्क्रिप्टालजि किञ्चित् पठनीयं. विभिन्नलिपीनां परिज्ञानम् अपेक्षितं.
तत्र तस्मिन् विषये मेनुस्क्रिप्टालजि किं भवतः कलाशाला किमपि कार्यं करोति वा तस्मिन् विषये?
न, मेनुस्क्रिप्टालजि अत्र नास्ति. अत्र तिरुपति वैदिक यूनिवर्सिटी वर्तते किल तत्र अनन्तरं राष्ट्रीय संस्कृत विद्यापीठम् इति नाम्ना आसीत् इदानीं संस्कृत विश्वविद्यालयः अस्ति तत्र च वर्तते मैनुस्क्रिप्टालजी तत्र संस्कृतस्य कृते मैनुस्क्रिप्टालजी इत्युक्तौ प्रायेण ब्राह्मी शारदा नन्दीनागरी ग्रन्थलिपि इमाः लिपयः पाठ्यन्ते तासां लिपीनां परिज्ञानं सम्पाद्य वस्तुतः एकं डेटा वदति संस्कृते 90% ग्रन्थाः न प्रकाशिताः
सत्यं
तालपत्ररूपेणैव सन्ति 90% GOML इति अस्ति गवर्नमेंट मैनुस्क्रिप्ट लाइब्रेरी इति अस्ति GOML
ओके
ओरिएंटल मैनुस्क्रिप्ट लाइब्रेरी इति इदानीं अडयार मध्ये चेन्नई मध्ये अस्ति बहवः ग्रन्थाः मम सुहृद्वर्यः तत्र लाइब्रेरियन वर्तते संस्कृतज्ञः एव सः शिवगुह नामकः महान् ग्रन्थराशि तत्र बहवः ग्रन्थाः अप्रकाशिताः एव अस्माकं कियत् ज्ञानं वर्तते पश्यन्तु अप्रकाशित पुस्तकरूपेण सन्ति तत्सर्वं पठित्वा इदानीं संस्कृतभाषापरिज्ञानेन तत्र बहु प्राजेक्ट्स् इदानीं राष्ट्रीयसंस्कृतसंस्थानं वर्तते किल तत्र तेषाम् 18 प्राजेक्ट् इति वर्तते तत्र संस्कृतस्कालर्स् एन्रोल् ते रिक्रूट् कुर्वन्ति तत्र स्वीकृत्य बहु इदं तालपत्राणां प्रकाशनार्थं अथवा तालपत्रमित्येव न रिटर्न् मेनुस्क्रिप्ट्स् नाम पेपर् तत्र फोलियो मध्ये रिटर्न् मेनुस्क्रिप्ट्स् बहु अस्ति तत्सर्वम् अप्रकाशितग्रन्थानां प्रकाशनार्थं बहुविध प्राजेक्ट्स् 18 कैण्ड् आफ़् सान्स्क्रिप्ट् प्राजेक्ट्स् आर् दर् फ्रीलान्सर् रूपेण अस्माभिः एव तत्र अप्लै कृत्वा तत्र किं किं स्कोप् अस्ति संस्कृतविदुषः सान्स्क्रिट् स्कालर् तस्य किं किम् उपरि करियर् आपर्चुनिटीस् अस्ति इति तत्र 18 प्राजेक्ट् द्रष्टुं शक्यते
अवकाशः लभ्यते तेषामपि लिङ्क् एकवारं लिङ्क्स्
प्रेषयामि अवश्यं ददामि अनन्तरं चमूकृष्णशास्त्रिणः महान्तः बहवः सन्ति तेषां सकाशादपि बहु परिज्ञानं सम्पादयितुं शक्यते करियर् आपर्चुनिटीस् अधिकृत्य संस्कृतज्ञानं बहु कर्तुं शक्यते अनन्तरं अत्र पाण्डिचेरी मध्ये अरबिन्दु इदमस्ति किल तत्र अस्माकम् अत्यन्तं परिचिताः मान्याः सम्पदानन्दमिश्रमहोदयाः सन्ति ते अपि बहु किं किम् अवकाशादिकम् अस्ति संस्कृतविदुषः नाम संस्कृतं ये पठितवन्तः तेषां निकटे अपि बहु प्राजेक्ट्स् सन्ति
किञ्चित् वक्तुम् इच्छामि सो दिस् क्वेश्चन् एस्पेशलि दिस् इस् एक्स्ट्रीम्लि रेलेवेण्ट् अट् दिस् टैम् बिकास् जनरलि द पर्सेप्शन् इन् द वर्ल्ड् अण्ड् इट्लि टु सम् एक्स्टेण्ट् द रियालिटि हेस् आल्सो बीन् टु सम् एक्स्टेण्ट् ट्रू दट् द केरियर् प्रास्पेक्ट्स् इफ् एस्पेशलि इफ् वन् लर्न्स् क्लासिकल् आर्ट्स् or something which is not very utilitarian in the world like probably chartered accountancy or engineering or doctor compared to that there has been a perception that these kind of soft skills are not as employable but slowly but certainly the tide is turning not just professors or priests are are the avenues for Sanskrit there are the, as Mahodaya was just saying there are thousands and thousands of volumes there are 90% as he was saying the existing knowledge that we have is so much but that is just the tip of the iceberg and there's so much which is yet to be dug out there are so many fields of study who are still searching for their base text which is there lying somewhere which needs to be researched and imagine the kind of research opportunities and especially with the growth of all these automated tasks for mundane things so from surgeries to building big buildings or from electronic stuff there is so much automation happening after a certain time it in my perception there will come a time it might be very close that all these pursuits of just external well-being are done and as it was in the past in Bharat where people had enough of sustenance and survival all around taken care of then they ventured into natya into kala into different kinds of artistic pursuits and about one's own inner sense of exploration, inner explorations. Even Tarka Sangraha, when I translated it as logical reasoning, it's not just logical reasoning at a surface level. It is the most about logical reasoning targeted at the life process itself, about the way in which it looks upon logical reasoning on the very process of logical reasoning. It's meta to another level. So these kind of finer pursuits of life will start to get more appreciated more and more. And wherever there is this appreciation, there is value, there is certainly success in terms of monetary returns. On top of that, as Mahodaya mentioned, there are many avenues for research, there are many avenues for exploration, and there are many projects which are ongoing. So yes, the career prospects are definitely much better than how they were before. Having said that, thank you so much, Mahodaya. We are 1 hour 25 minutes. Can we take one more question, or is it okay? I'll see if there are any relevant questions which have to be asked. Guys, sorry, I can't address questions on YouTube. There are some generic questions. Guys, any questions pertaining to the course itself? The details will be there on the website. So about the fees, about how many lessons or modules each of them have, about the prerequisites for each of the courses. I'm guessing, Mahodaya, all this detail is there on the website itself. And there are no very specific questions that I can probably ask from you. There is somebody Neha ji asks, are there any scholarship opportunities that the university provides, or is there anything?
Campus madhye ye atra chhatravasena saha patanti tesham asti. Online madhyamena ye patanti tesham idanim nasti.
Astu. So guys who are enrolled in the college, who are doing the courses there and in person, have such opportunities. The college supports them through scholarships, but online courses, they don't have any scholarships yet. Thank you so much, Mahodaya. Dhanyavadaha, Bhurishaha dhanyavadaha.
अत्यन्तं भवतः कृते मम हार्दिक कृतज्ञताः अहं निवेदयितुम् इच्छामि इदानीं.
धन्यवादः.
एतादृशसेवा भवता या क्रियते संस्कृतभाषायाः, भारतीय संस्कृतेश्च, अत्यन्तं श्लाघार्हः भवति. भवतः तत्र उद्यमः महान् वर्तते इति, उपरि भवतां प्रगतिः तत्र भवतु इति अहं देवं प्रार्थये.
थ्याङ्क् यू सो मच्. नमस्कारः. शुभरात्रि भवति अपि सर्वेभ्यः अपि शुभरात्रिः सर्वेभ्यः. सो बिफोर, थैंक यू सो मच हरिहरन जी फॉर जॉइनिंग इन. आई होप यू आर एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट हरिहरन जी मेंशन्ड टू अ लार्ज एक्सटेंट. ही वाज ऑफ कोर्स वेरी स्वीट इन प्रेजेंटिंग ऑल हिज कंटेंट इन एज सिंपल ए संस्कृत एज पॉसिबल, बीइंग अ स्कॉलर दैट ही इज. एंड आई होप आई नो नाउ लेट मी ट्राई एंड एड्रेस सम ऑफ द कॉमन क्वेश्चंस. Guys, what sorts of questions you have? Simha, that is taken care of. How can we make all temple administration run in Sanskrit language? Most of them already do. Who is asking this question? Sai Shashiji. Most of them already do. It's, but administrations, to put... I don't know how to address. This is a very vague question. Are there any specific questions, guys? Let me come to YouTube. What's going on here? Thank you. And a lot of it written in Devanagari script, which is hard to read from this distance. 10th standard past students. Hrituji, you can check the website. You'll be able to check it there. But all the hundreds of people watching us on both the channels, thank you so much for joining us this evening. Once again, a very, very happy Independence Day to all of you. Let us... This nation and its strength, the backbone of Indian civilization, the civilization of Bharat as we call it, is its Sanskriti, or the rich traditions and culture that we have been inherited, which has been inherited to us. It is, as I said before, there is a tide turning, as I see it, with World Sanskrit Day coming up on 22nd of August. We have big things planned. I'm sure many institutions across the country have big things planned for Shravana Purnima. which is World Sanskrit Day, as it celebrated Raksha Bandhan the same day. Why I was saying that is the backbone of that Sanskriti is Sanskrit, the language Sanskrit. And it was an absolute pleasure having received even a response from the Madras Sanskrit College and being offered an overview of all the courses they have in their institute. If any of you are interested, I'm sure many of you are, you can check out their website and the courses and the app. And there is, of course, their YouTube channel. Please go to the YouTube channel there also and show them some love. And I have tagged their channel on the title of this video. Thank you so much, everyone, for joining in. And see you in the next video on the channel or in one of our live streams. Thank you so much for joining in. Shubharatri. Shubharatri.